today is all about...
She did this to me earlier. I had no idea what she was doing.
Love. We're gonna talk about our wedding and we're gonna show you our highlight video. We defaulted to December, New Year's Eve. That's when we got married.
What we thought it'd be cool was it was gonna be winter and like everything else pretty much sucks, but it's a celebration.
Yeah. So what happened is like my whole family, pretty much like all my cousins and stuff, and my sister got married the same year. And they picked like fallish, end of summer, fall. I didn't wanna get married in spring because my birthday's in spring, so I just didn't want to. Yeah, too much to focus on. I like to spread out the months that I'm spoiled.
Also makes for a really good anniversary because then you can trip when it's freezing. Here anyways in New England.
Yeah, so we go on vacation for our anniversary trip and it's always somewhere warm, so it's nice to get away. So we did a New Year's Eve wedding. It was literally the best thing ever. It was so amazing. I feel like no one forgets our anniversary either because it was New Year's Eve and it actually ended up snowing, so.
Blizzard.
Yeah, it.
3 feet.
Mm-hmm. It blizzard right before our wedding, so a lot of people actually canceled last minute because they couldn't travel. We just wanted everyone to be safe. We were so thankful for the people that did come. It was so fun. We got married in Indiana, like where Notre Dame is. So we rented Airbnbs and stuff and stayed there for the whole weekend. We did like a late ceremony, like started at 6, our reception, and everyone started eating at like 9, so it was late, but...
Yeah, but we always said people always think they have something to do on New Year's Eve, but if you actually ask people, they say they have something, but they won't tell you what because they don't know. No one knows what they're doing on New Year's Eve.
But they always want to have something to do.
Yes.
An excuse to like dress up nice and go to a big party.
Change your tux.
John changed his suit. So for the ceremony, he was in a black tux. And then for the reception, he was in a maroon suit. We got married in a theater, not a movie theater. What do you call it? Like a...
Performing arts.
Yeah. John surprised me during the wedding. I knew everything that was supposed to happen. And then... on stage, he looked like he was confused. And I was like, you have to do this next, you know? So I'm like whispering that to him. And then he surprised me.
I have to tell him with the song. I literally broke out into a musical. My least favorite thing.
He actually likes it, but he wants to pretend like he doesn't like it. And he made this whole spiel about his first debut being on stage.
A Broadway stage, yeah.
Yeah.
It's on my resume.
He sang. It wasn't a cappella, but that's okay.
Well, it was supposed to be, but I didn't have the vocal range of Chris Rice. Well, no, I do. I actually have the exact same vocal range, but all of the, what's it called, music without the words?
Instrumentals.
All the instrumentals were like a totally different key. Or octave, whatever it was not gonna happen. And plus we couldn't find one that worked anyways that wasn't just with random people in it. So, place that all the Notre Damers go, it's Brothers, and we had just gone there the night before, just hanging out, all the guys and stuff, and the AV guy for our wedding just happened to be there. We'd only met him once, and he's like, hey, and I didn't even know who he was. And he's like, what's up, man? And I was like, oh my goodness, this is just fate. I was like, look, I have a song that I might sing tomorrow. And I was like, could you play? He's like, totally, I could totally do that. I don't know where this guy came from. Anyways, I just could not find one that worked, so I actually duet with Chris Rice for that song. It was a little embarrassing, but it was the only way, and I ran into him, and I was like, I guess I have to do this.
Which we'll show you right now.
Maybe just a snippet.
We'll show you.
Not the whole thing.
We'll show you.
You ask us for it.
I never let anybody hear me sing, and I always joke that I'll sing you a song when we get married. I didn't want to be a liar. That, and I figured I might as well get married and make my Broadway debut on the same day. So, the song is by Chris Rice. I heard it in high school when I didn't know anything. I had a friend that was always singing, listening to music. So definitely there's a reason I don't let people hear me sing. So listen to the words. Because it's a really nice one. It's called When Did You Fall? And I've been pretty known for being the clueless lover. I'm the last to figure out when someone likes me. It took a while for Michelle. But it really goes through because we went through so many phases. It's been so long. And yeah, just listen. And the karaoke version was like 2 octaves higher, so I had to, I'm gonna be accompanied by Chris Rice.
Chris Rice, but I don't think he got as many tears as you did.
We actually went to dance lessons.
We had a choreographed first dance. Anyways, it was nice. It was fun.
We didn't complete the lessons.
No, because it was like a cult. You had to come once, and then they have you coming again. Then we bought like a, you know, 5-visit thing. We didn't even go to the 5th visit because they literally just suck you in and you have to do all these dances. Dance night, dance this, subscribe. I don't know. It was like we joined a thing and it was not.
And it was so expensive, like to do anything extra.
Yes.
And we
had, like, guilt you into not doing it if you didn't want to do it.
And
like,
we had already paid a lot.
They're like, oh, you don't want to do the extra salsa? What? And we're like, no.
Yeah, yes. Anyways, our first dance, I feel like, went well. For our first dance.
Well, yeah, because it was choreographed. Otherwise, Michelle really likes to be
well,
the
we
lead.
Didn't finish the choreography. So we just had to, like, practice and we just made up, like, an ending to it. But it turned out fine. As you can see, we're, like, walking in super elegantly. We presented ourselves like on this balcony and then we had to walk down the stairs. And then everyone always laughs at this part where I'm like putting my hand out and I'm like holding my dress.
She's gonna touch the audience or something.
Yeah. Okay, I felt like a princess and I acted like a princess. I mean, it is what it is. Like, I fully admit that. And is it obnoxious? Yeah, probably. New Year's Eve, I would recommend it. It's so fun. You're with everyone that you love the most, like celebrating New Year's Eve too, bringing in the new year. So that's our story. That's our little wedding snippet. And we'll show you the highlight now. We will be doing our laundry room makeover video next week. Stay tuned for that. Don't forget to press subscribe and like if you guys are down to see the laundry room makeover video next week.
Juicy.
Mm-hmm. Super interesting. All of John's trips to Lowe's that he's loves so much.
A little bit sore on that.
Okay, guys.
But I'll teach you how to save. They won't like it, but you will.
How about you end it this time?
That was a pretty good ending. Savings. Money. It's my forte. We'll throw some finance videos in there for you too. Those are coming. That you'll like. So you gotta subscribe. But we will see you next time on... I don't want to say the names.
Why?
We'll see ya.
On.
Oh, keeping up with.
The Khargies.
Okay.
Bye, love you guys.
Dear Mimi, time with you has a very different effect. All the things we've done, all the adventures and the ridiculous trips, it seems like a lifetime of events. But when I look at you, it still seems like just yesterday we were sneaking out, going to the beach as friends, and just enjoying each other's company as young, naive kids. But the best part of that is that I will get to enjoy your timelessness forever. That is the most amazing gift, and I feel totally undeserving. You are better than me in every single way, from your hair to your heart. I love you, you already complete me, and now you just have to change your name. Muchos besos, I love you, love you, love you, and you are going to kill me in that dress. Love, John John.
My dear Johnny, there is not a year, month, day, hour, or minute that goes by without me being so incredibly humbled and grateful to God for placing you in my life. Even though the majority of our relationship were plane tickets and long drives to see each other, you have always been there for me. Today is the day we have dreamt about for so long, but I want you to know that after we are announced Mr. and Mrs. Khargie and the party comes to an end, my love, my vows, and my loyalty remains yours forever. I promise to love you more each day, kiss you each morning, pray with you every evening, and grow old with you until death do us part. You were, are, and will be mine forever from this day forward.
John and Michelle on this huge milestone in life.
When we see you together, your love always shines through. God was clearly responsible for connecting the two of you.
Now as you begin this journey together, we have all the faith that your love will last forever.
Cheers to Michelle and John.